Hello and welcome. To get started, I would like to acknowledge the traditional owners of the land that I am presenting on today, the Whadjuk Noongar people, paying deep respects to elders past, present, and emerging. This video is a short demonstration of the herbal medicine resources available through the Endeavour College Library. I'm starting on the library website, available through the Library tab in your LMS, or you can search Endeavour Library and find this page through the web. I'm going to navigate to the library guides on the left-hand side. From this list of library guides, I'm going to scroll down and select naturopathy down the very bottom here. In this guide, you can see a number of tabs along the top here. I'm going to select the herbal medicine tab. This opens up to the herbal medicine library guide. The resources I'm going to be taking you through in this session can be found in this box on the left-hand side here. It's titled WHMF212 Herbal Monograph because there is an assignment under this course code that these sources are particularly helpful when researching. However, they are just genuinely great herbal medicine resources that are applicable to any kind of research in this field. So if you're not studying this course code, don't feel like this isn't going to be relevant. It just has been housed in this box here to make it nice and easily accessible. The databases that I'm going to be taking you through are Natural Medicines, the American Botanical Council, and Martindale. These are all modern herbal sources. They can also be found in this tab here up the top, databases and journals. They're just listed in a longer list. So I've navigated to this page here just because it's a lot easier to find them in this left-hand side box here. So the first resource I'm going to take you into is Natural Medicines, this first one here. I'm going to click in here. You will be asked to log in with your student number and your LMS password. This just ensures that you are an Endeavour student because you can just access this content from the web. I'm going to log in with my staff login. And this opens up to the Natural Medicines database. So navigating from this landing page here, I'm going to go up the top and hover over databases, this little tab up the top here. The very first one you can see me hovering over with my mouse is titled Food, Herbs, and Supplements. If I click on this, it opens up to an alphabetized listing of all of the food, herbs, and supplements that there is entries on in this database. The example that I'm going to use for this session is valerian. So I'm going to go along the top here, select V. And you can see valerian is the first V entry we have in this list. So I'm going to select my herb. So this opens up to the information page on this particular herb. What I'm going to point out at the beginning are these two sections at the top. So there is some information under scientific name, which I can actually expand out to show more scientific names. And then also here, there is common names. And if I open up this little drop down, it gives me a listing of other common names that this herb can be referred to. So already we're starting off with multiple keywords that we could use to search in other databases. You can navigate on the left-hand side to the particular area you're interested in, or you can just scroll down the page. There is safety information, adverse effects, and effectiveness. We can see from this very first entry, insomnia is listed as something that this herb is possibly effective at treating. If I click on this little details one here, it'll open up to more information. So, Natural Medicines is a modern herbal source. It is also a secondary source database, which means that the information it's collating here has been sourced through other journal articles and research. Then the database has collated that information together to make an entry with more generalized information, so a snapshot of the research available. You'll notice that in these paragraphs, we have these little blue links. These are all references. So all of these little numbers here are references to other articles, other research that was used to write up this information. If I click on one of them, I'm going to click on this one here. It takes us to the reference list entry. If I select View Abstract, it will open up to a page like this with more information about this source. So you can see here that this is referencing a randomized placebo-controlled trial, which means it's very likely a primary research article. Sometimes there are free full-text access available to these articles through the web. So for example, you can see here there is a full-text link here. If this wasn't the case, and sometimes it's not, It's just sometimes there's an open access record available on the web in full text. Sometimes there's not. If there isn't, I can always copy and paste the title or the DOI of this article into a discovery search and see if the library has paid access to this content. We're lucky in this case, there is a free text link. So if I click on this, it opens up to the full text of this article. And if I scroll down, you can see I've got the full information here. I recommend Natural Medicines is a really good place to start your research because it is a secondary source database. You can see the snapshot of research out there, and it also has these other common names and scientific names listed at the top, which provide you with more keywords you can use when searching other databases. And looking down this list, there are other points of interest such as dosage and administration information, drug interactions, as well as commercial products that use this herb, and mechanisms of action as well. The next database I'm going to take you through is the American Botanical Council. It's right underneath the natural medicines in this list. You'll see underneath we have a username and password information. So if I open up this modern herbal source, this is the landing page that we arrive at. There is a pink little button at the top here that says login. If I hit this, in this login, I'm including that password we have sitting just underneath it here, the username and password here, logging in with that. Now I have access to the full resource. You can see up the top here, I'm logged in under Endeavor College. Next, I'm going to navigate to this little resources button up the top here and just hover over it. There are quite a few resources which are helpful in this source. First one being Herbalgram. Herbalgram is a herbal medicines journal that publish specifically in the field of herbal medicine. There is also the Herbal Medicine Expanded Commission's e-monographs. If I click into this, you'll see it opens up in an A to Z listing of the herbs that are listed in this particular resource. If I scroll all the way down, I do have an entry under valerian root. And you'll see there is an entry in a very similar layout to what was in Natural Medicines. We have an overview, description, uses, interactions with other drugs and side effects, including a reference list at the end. And you can see through the content here, there are multiple resources being referenced, which are all listed in the reference list at the end. So this is another secondary modern herbal resource. And before I navigate away from this, I'm just going to make sure I log out before I close the resource. The last modern herbal source we have in this list is Martindale under the Medicines Complete eBooks. Medicines Complete is an online host for eBooks. And this research searches two online books, Herbal Medicines, which we have here, and Martindale, the Complete Drug Reference. You can search both of them at the same time if you select both publications. I'm going to search my keyword in here. Just hit enter. And that will search both of these online books. I have an entry in Martindale here, which I can view just by clicking on the link here. You'll see again, it has a very similar layout to the other resources we were using, with the subsections available on the left-hand side here and references included throughout. Going to go back to my results list, have a look at the herbal medicines entry. You can see this has a bit more information, quite a few more subsections available on the left-hand side here. Again, following a very similar outline to what we've seen on the other resources we were researching in, including synonyms. Herbal uses, dosage information, possible side effects, and drug interactions. Again, with a reference list available at the end. A common question we get in the library is how to actually reference these kinds of resources. So I'm going to navigate back to the library homepage. From the library homepage, I'm going to select referencing again in that left-hand side list. And then from here, I'm going to select the knowledge base. knowledge base houses questions that are maybe a little bit too specific for us to put in a general referencing guide, but are still asked often enough that we feel we should have an answer available that students can access themselves. So I'm just going to type in medicines complete. It's best to search this little box at the top here with very specific keywords, because that's more likely to hit the entries we have in this little searchable knowledge base. The very first entry I have here is how to reference something that is housed in Medicines Complete, like those two ebooks are. And you'll see underneath there's actually on how to reference natural medicines as well, which was the first database that I used in this presentation. So there is information on how to reference these kinds of resources through the library. Definitely search the knowledge base. But if you're still confused or maybe want to double check, feel free to reach out to the virtual librarian or your campus librarian to double check your references. The last resource I want to point out on this herbal medicine libguide, I'm actually going to scroll down, and on the right hand side, we have a box titled traditional sources. Traditional sources is also something we get asked about, particularly when students are completing herbal medicine research. And we have an entire guide dedicated exclusively to traditional sources. If I click on this button here, it will take me to the guide. Alternatively, in this list of library guides that I got to just through the Endeavor Library homepage, we have a link to the traditional sources guide here as well. So both of those links take us to this guide here. The great thing about traditional sources is because they are older texts, they are often out of copyright, which means we can link to the full text of these resources without any copyright restrictions. In navigating this page, you can see we've broken these links into subject areas. Don't feel like you have to stay in just one area. Feel free to experiment. There's just a lot of content and a lot of links through this library guide. We wanted to make it a little bit less overwhelming, so we've tried to break them up a little bit. The stars next to these resources means that we've had students give us good feedback about them in the past, and we found that they're particularly helpful resources. Again, because these are quite a long list of stuff, start with the ones that have been starred. But again, don't feel like you have to stick to that or stick to just one subject list. A lot of the time you'll find there is some overlap. We do have a dedicated video on how to use these traditional sources. All of them appear a little bit differently. Sometimes they'll be scanned books. Sometimes they'll look like websites where the content of a particular book has been digitized and uploaded to look like a web page. For example, I'm going to click into this Culpepper's Complete Herbal here. This one is actually displayed like an actual book. You can see the original book has been scanned. You can use the contents page to navigate to the particular section that we're interested in, or there is a little magnifying glass up the left-hand side here. I'm going to click on this, and this allows me to search inside this book. Again, I'm just going to throw in my herb. And that actually scans all of the actual content in this book and brings back a list on the left-hand side of where this keyword has been found within the book. I'm going to scroll down. I feel like this might be a good entry. Yep. And after clicking on that entry, it opens up to the section of the book where that particular word is sitting. The thing to remember when using traditional sources is the language used in these traditional texts will reflect the time that they are written. You're sometimes searching the scientific name of particular herbs, don't bring up results just because they're being referred to in a common name that was very widely used at the time the text was being written. In that case, I recommend going back to that natural medicines database, having a look at those other common names of the herb that you are researching and trying those if you're not finding any entries in these resources with the current keywords that you're using. Again, traditional texts can be a little bit difficult to reference, particularly because sometimes they'll have the author's like death date mixed in there, so you're not quite sure if it's the publication date or the death date. Sometimes the titles of the books can be very long and convoluted, in which case we have also included referencing information for every single one of the book resources. If there's something like this, which is actually an online archive that houses our resources, there's not a reference list entry for it because this isn't going to a particular resource, it's going to an online archive. But the books that are available, if you hover over these little eye icons, we APA 7 referencing information pops up here. Unfortunately, you can't copy and paste from these little boxes. We wanted to include the referencing information and we found these little eye icons probably like the least overwhelming because there is already a lot of content on these pages. All you have to do is hover over this little eye icon, copy the content that we have in this box here, word for word, and then update with the correct formatting. Just the nature of these little pop-ups, it doesn't let us italicize the book title or include a hanging indent. So this is what it looks like to start with. This is just the straight referencing information. If I was using that in an assignment, I would update it to look like this. So you can see I've included the hanging indent here and I've italicized the title of the book itself. This text is an interesting one because we do have an original publication date, but it has actually been republished recently. So in that case, we include the republication date in our references entry here and the original publication date at the end. Then for our end text referencing, we include both the original publication date and the republished date. Again, this can be something that's a little bit tricky with these traditional sources, but the referencing information is available through that guide, like we have here. And if you do have any questions or aren't quite sure before you submit your references, feel free to reach out to the library to check your referencing. You can either reach out to your campus librarian, you can use the virtual librarian chat on the right-hand side of the website here, or again, navigating back to the library homepage, you can book a consultation with the librarian as well, and we can give you feedback on your research and your referencing. That concludes this presentation on herbal medicine resources available through the Endeavor Library. Thank you so much for watching and good luck with your future endeavors.